Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. The Haitian proverb says, "Sickness does not fall on trees, but on people." In this video, you will learn what HIV, or human immunodeficiency virus, is, how it gets in your body, and how it makes you sick. What is an immune system? The immune system is the body's germ-fighting system. What are T cells or CD4 cells? They are part of the immune system. They are like tiny warriors inside a person's blood that fight bacteria and viruses and protect you from the infection they cause. What is a virus? A tiny germ that gets inside the body of a person. Once inside, it makes thousands of copies of itself and causes a person to get sick. A virus causes diseases like chickenpox, the common cold, and coronavirus, or COVID-19. Regular antibiotics cannot kill a virus because it requires special medication. What is human immunodeficiency virus, or HIV? What is AIDS? HIV is a virus that attacks the immune system, making the body weaker. HIV makes it hard for a person to fight off infections. AIDS, or acquired immune deficiency syndrome, is a condition that affects a person who has had HIV for a long time. A person with AIDS has a very weak immune system and can get very sick. How does an adult get HIV? They can get it through sexual contact with a person with HIV. They can get it by sharing needles during drug use or tattooing a person with HIV. They can get it by getting stuck with a needle that was used by a person with HIV. How does a child get HIV? This can happen when a mother is infected with HIV and does not take medicine to control the HIV during pregnancy. It can happen during childbirth if the mother is not taking HIV medicine. It can happen when a mother with HIV breastfeeds a baby. How does HIV hurt me? HIV virus attacks your immune system and makes it weak. This means that a person can get sick more easily. There is no cure for HIV, but there is very effective treatment, like that for high blood pressure or diabetes. How do I know if I have HIV? 2 to 4 weeks after having sexual contact or sharing a needle with an infected person, that person may have a fever, rash, muscle pain, headache, and other problems. The virus makes copies of itself very quickly and spreads throughout the body. The number of viruses in the blood is very high at this time, and the chance of passing HIV to another person is very high. This period of time is called the early stage of HIV. This is also called the incubation or acute phase. A blood test can tell if a person has HIV. In the second stage of HIV, the virus continues to grow inside the blood, but at lower levels. A person in this stage may not feel sick for many years. The final stage of HIV is called AIDS. This stage is dangerous because the virus has hurt the immune system for a long time. The immune system is weak and can't fight off certain infections, called opportunistic infections. A blood test can reveal if a person has AIDS. The test shows that a person has less than 200 CD4 cells, or warriors. The normal amount of CD4 cells is 600 to 900. A person with AIDS has many copies of the virus and can pass HIV to others very easily. Without treatment, a person with AIDS can die in 3 years or less. The amount of virus in blood can be directly measured via a blood test called quantitative viral load. Doctors use this test routinely to measure if the medications are working. You have reached the end of this video. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Today you learned about HIV, how it enters the body, what it can do to the body, and how doctors can tell how much HIV is in the body. If you have questions, please talk to your nurse or doctor.